This is Samuel Colt, the founder of the Colt Revolver and one of the most important figures in American history. His revolver, highly popularized by the Mexican-American War, was far superior to the other firearms and technologies during its time period. It contained 5 to 6 bullets at a time and could launch them farther than any firearm. This made it simple for American troops to outgun their enemies and win the battles, which in turn gained the U.S. the western part of our country. Samuel Colt, son of Christopher and Sarah Colt, was a natural-born inventor. As a child, he worked in his father's textile factory, and by the age of 11, he went to a school in Glastonbury where he occupied himself with his education and farm work. At that school, he first came in contact with the Encyclopedia Compendium of Knowledge. This solidified his idea to become an inventor. Many of the inventions in the book really grasped his interest, but being able to shoot multiple rounds in quick succession really caught his attention. At the age of 16, he went on a merchant ship to travel around the world and study navigation firsthand. Aboard the ship, Colt was fascinated by the ship's wheel because it could alternately spin or be locked in a fixed position. This gave him the idea to carve a wooden representation of the revolver during the rest of his voyage. Upon his return, Samuel showed his father the wooden carving and asked to get it built. Christopher hired 2 low-budget blacksmiths to make the guns, but they were both a complete failure. This did not stop him. He went on the road to perform an entertainment act under the name of Dr. Colt. He would put on a chemical lecture about the effects of nitrous oxide. Soon he had enough money to fund a skilled blacksmith to make his prototype revolver. In 1835, he traveled to England to get his patents for his revolver, and later in 1836 he got the patents in the US as well. Colt's first armory was built in Whitneysville, Connecticut, but it was soon replaced by a larger factory in Hartford. This armory was located right next to the Connecticut River and was huge. It included housing, a library, and a public hall. Each one of Colt's revolvers could be quickly assembled by a small assembly line, and they were very affordable. Colt's firearms were first sent in the hands of U.S. soldiers during the Seminole War. 152 caliber 6-shot rifles were given to the 2nd U.S. Dragoon for trial. However, Colt's revolving arms made their major appearance during the Mexican-American War, when the U.S. War Department ordered 1,000 Colt Whitneyville revolvers. The use of the revolvers helped win the war and gain territory in the U.S. If Colt had not created these revolvers, American victory would have been very difficult in the West. Colt continued to innovate his revolver and other firearms until January 10, 1862, when he died, at the age of 47. During his lifetime, he produced and sold more than 400,000 guns, and his estate he earned was worth $15 million. Following his death, the control of the company was left to his wife, Elizabeth Jarvis, and her family until 1901, when it was sold to a group of investors. In 1864, the Colt Armory and adjacent office burned to the ground, causing a 3-year standstill in military weaponry production. Fortunately, the factory was rebuilt in 1867 and still stands today. Despite the major setback, the company continued to manufacture firearms. In 1911, the U.S. Army adopted the Colt 45 designed by John M. Browning to be their official sidearm, and that gun has been one of the most iconic and popular firearms to date. Colt produced the most recognizable and reliable weapons in the world. His famous multi-shot revolvers immediately associated with American Wild West and the Western expansion. Without his designs, we might have still been stuck in the age of flintlock muskets and pistols. His legacy will always live on.